Okay, I think I will start now. So today I will update the i20 WRC setup that I did earlier on this summer. Why I'm doing this is because I got extremely nice opportunity to be on the co-driver seat of the real-life rally car, the Skoda Fabia R5. It was driven by Ville Pynnönen, and it was his test day here in Finland, and well, I don't know what to say. It gave me so much information about what it is and how it is to be on the real car and how it handles, what is the grip and all kind of that. There was two main things that I noticed. First was the grip. The level of the grip is huge. It's so much better than on the Richard Burns rally. And I think it's not even possible to get so much grip whatever you do on the setup. But for sure, I have to find more grip on my setup, make it match better to the real life. And it was amazing that there was just a lot of grip, because the car was still really stiff. You know, the suspension, it was really stiff. And on Richard Burns rally, if you want the car to be stiff, it will not give you the grip. Only way to get a lot of grip is to make the suspension soft. But I have a few ideas what to try to find more grip without making the car too soft. And the grip was the first thing. And the second thing that I noticed on the real life car was the ability to continue the turning and continue the rotating of the car. Because on Richard Burns rally, it's quite easy to make the car to turn well. The first impact, good. It's easy to make it good. But how the car continues turning, it's not so easy anymore. And it was amazing on the real life how well the car behaved. Ville didn't have to throw the car in. He just turned the steering wheel. And with the straight car, the car turns very well through the whole corner. So that is something what I want to try today, and I have a few ideas what to do. Well, but I think I will talk more when I'm doing the things. And now I do a few runs at the beginning because I haven't been driven today at all, so a little bit like a warm-up. And remembering again this setup, I did few runs yesterday, but not so much that I work extremely well what I have done. Yeah, now this is the correct setup and the setup that I shared on the early summer. So let's do a few runs, one on the Sirion head and I think one on a new Ruuhimäki stage, because I have a really good touch on the stage.
3, 2, 1, go, 4 left, and left short by right, and left short 3 left plus, double caution, 50, 90 left, give in. And dead short, 90 right, don't cut, 30. 3 left, extra long, give in.
I'm just starting it.
And dead 34 right, give in. Don't
get the
cut.
Feeling how the suspension is doing and how the dampers right, are doing.
40, 90 left,
I think I can the co-driver off. So yeah,
right,
feeling the car a bit.
Long,
it is over 2 months that I did this setup, and after that realized, why is not going mute? Now we have silence, I think. Yeah, so I have done a few setups after that in real life rally experience. So I know a little bit what I'm doing and what I will do. And I can see that on these setups, first what I notice is the length of the suspension travel, especially the travel in. I think it's too much. Of course, it was the R5, the car that I has the, have the experience, but I think still this is too much. Let's see from the outside. I think it's a little bit too long travel and too soft suspension, but if I remember correct, it was really critical, the suspension and the fast pump dampers, when I was setting the jumping behavior on Olinpohja. So I have to be really careful, I don't want to disturb that good jumping if I will do some changes to the spring settings. Yeah, and another thing that is really easy to notice is that the front is not going down as quick as I want. So the slow damping on the front is, I would say, a lot too stiff. It feels really stiff now. I think I'm ready to go to the room again. And one thing I want to say, what comes to the this kind of updating thing, that even without that real life experience, it's good to update your setups. You know, if you are doing setups, you are developing yourself all the time. You are learning new tricks, so good to update your setups. It may feel good when you have been driving like tens of hours the setup, and then if you take a month or two break, you can feel things different after the break. So good thing even without that real life experience. Let's go to the room again. Let's start the changes. And why I'm driving the Ruuhimäki now is because it is it just came online to the Rallyesim fan plugin, the Hungarian plugin. And there was some proper hot lapping going on. So I knew the stage really well and I have good feeling to the stage. So I think it's good stage to test also. I know exactly how I want the car to behave on the corners. And there's also a lot of junctions, and I think the junctions are a really good place to test the turning of the car, because I'm going to make the turning better from the suspension, so I could continue the turning through the wall corner. But it will be so good turning that I have to make the rear, what is it, preload of the rear differential a lot higher, I think. And maybe also the center differential from the low speeds. I need to make that stiffer, so the car won't over-rotate on the low speed. But I can still use the good rotating suspension and dampers for the high speed long corners, so I can continue the turning. But let's drive one more time without changes and then start the real work. The medium gearbox on this stage, I think the long gearbox is better. Yeah, it's so easy to feel now that the rear of the car is really loose. It's so easy to rotate the car, but it's just the first part of the corner, the braking and the turning. It doesn't help you to turn in on the apex of the corner and the late part of the corner, where I'm going to need more of the turning ability. So that has been, I can say, a mistake from me, what I have been doing before that real life experience, that I have been making the turning from the differentials, from the open differentials, especially on the back, and not so much on the suspension. I have two stiff suspension on the front and two open diff on the back compared to the real life, and especially the behavior on the real life. Of course, I don't know how the setup are on the real life i20 WRC, but somehow I can see how it's behaving, and after that real life experience opened my eyes even more how the cars are going in real life. I will also change a little bit the camera angle. A little bit closer. Pit junction. Let's see if I can do the stage without base notes. I think I can. So it's more silence, so you can hear me better. Yeah, I have to like throw the car in and put a lot of work and power to the braking and the steering, because the front of the car is too stiff. I think it's not the spring, it's more the damper. Way too stiff. And yesterday I did a little bit tests. I tested a softer damper on the front, but just a really quick. It felt basically okay, but I didn't make any changes to the differential, so it was turning too good, especially on the high speed brakings. Much better on the big road. Here the stiffness of the front is helping more, giving stability of the car. But yeah, it's, you can see my steering wheel, but I was on the contest training through wall that braking. It's so easy to lose the rear. So let's start the work. Let's see first what we have. 40%. Well, it's not totally open, but I can use maybe more. But I think first I'm going to increase the preload value a lot. Same to the then the front. Then bump of the front dampers a lot softer. The 3.75 straight away. And I think these are the first changes I'm going to do. I want to check the central map. Well, it's quite stiff, but maybe because I had the really low preload on the rear, I have had to use the stiff values here. And that open value is really open, I think, compared to the newer setup that I have done for the Fiesta and the Yaris. I've been using like 35 and 40%. It helps a little bit that the car won't spin so easily when being on the really low speeds, like doing handbrake turns on the junction and hairpins. What we have on front? But let's start to feel how these changes feels. And I think if the behavior is good and there will be no problems, I'm not going to check the replay anymore, because we checked it last time on the last times many times, and it should be okay. The right hand and the rake should be realistic. It's still quite, you know, how would I say it? I need to put too much effort. It's not instant how the front goes down when I push the brakes. Little bit too, you know, difficult and slow. And it makes me to drive too aggressive, which is not good. I have to turn really much to the corners, and then I'm sliding. Right. It felt better how the front stays on the ground, but the speed is still too slow how the front is going to down. And it's turning. The turning is really good now, it's too good. I have to increase the preload or the brake load on the... not brake load, brake lock on the rear. But that's not a surprise. Quite easy to spin. Yeah, I really like the feeling now, how the front stays down after the braking. But the first impact when I touch the brake, it's too slow still. But it is better for sure. But I have to increase the diff on the rear a lot. Yeah, it's... takes too long time to go to the down, but when it's down, it's good. Let's put another 0.5 and then increase a lot of... let's try 60 straight away to the 60%. And I think I'm going to need more preload, but I'm not going to do it yet, so I can feel the effect of this brake lock change. I'm thinking all the time that I should make the mainspring a little shorter and stiffer, but I'm afraid a little bit that it will destroy the good jumping. Yeah, I will test it to the Ounin pohja again. Maybe the best stage to test the jumping. It's so difficult, the yellow house jump. It's quite close. And I think I can use more rebound on the rear. And that is one thing I want to tell, and one thing I'm planning to use a little bit softer pump values on the slow area of dampers, and use stiffer rebound values, make that setup to this way or that way, to gain the good grip without too nervous behaving. I think it may be the good way to get more grip without being too soft, because the grip is something I really want more. It is so grippy the real life. real life car, even the R5, and I think on WRC there's even more grip, especially on the high speeds, because of the downforce. It's not really feeling any better. Or again, it's better the feeling how the front stays down, but the first impact, it's still too slow. I think I'm really close to good brake lock now. It feels really good. Maybe a little bit more preload, but the brake lock itself seems quite good. Yeah, I'm not losing the rear anymore. If I lose the rear, it's the final end of the braking, and it's more like preload stuff than the actually brake lock stuff. Yeah, I want the car. Or the front of the car go faster down, still faster. Another 0.5 down, and then same time I can test the preload. I have preload. And I think after the braking and turning on the junction, then I will test the Joukkovaara and maybe Sirdonheed, because those were the stages where I tested a lot. I made the base setup on the spring. And then I want to try 10mm shorter springs on the Ouninpohja and see if the car can still jump good. Because I think a little bit stiffer and shorter spring will be closer to the real life. 3, 2, 1, go! And still it feels a little bit too slow. The really very first impact. The rest of the suspension travel is good, but the first impact. Yeah. At least the braking grip is a lot better. And it's more logical, it games more easier now. Whoa. Or preload. And maybe the rear of the car, the rear slow area of the dampers, can be a bit softer too. It gives me like instant grip when I push the throttle. It was so amazing on the real life car. When Ville went to the throttle, the car just pull straight out of the corner. Like no sliding at all. Almost make that corner without understeer. So it's going closer and closer. What comes to the front slow area damping. Let's drive a little bit further on the stage. Yeah, it's still now when it's so easy to feel on the downhill brakings that it's too stiff the front damping. But it's getting better and better on every change. Yeah, too difficult to turning. Also on a really high speed corners when the downforce is massive on the rear. Basically it's a really stable and runki on the Harri Rovanperä corner, and Thierry Neville also went off. Don't remember the year, maybe 2014. Rovanperä's off was 2004, maybe. Legendary Ruuhimäki jumps. It's not a 100% match to the real life, but you can recognize the stage. So yeah, let's continue the same way. Less damping on the front and more preload to the rear. And now I don't want to go a lot softer anymore. I think, and I hope I don't want to go, because on the jumping also, even we have these fast pump values, but the end of the damping, end of the landing, it will be quite, you know, slow. And then these slow values are active. And if they are extremely soft, the end of the landing, the end of the suspension compression, it will be really soft. So I don't want to go extremely low values, something like 1.0. How much should I put? Let's put the 30 more. Like that. And then also I want to test, same time, a little bit higher 0% lock, and the 0 speed lock will be the... It will give a little bit more stability on the really slow places like handbrake turns, I think. Yeah, I can also increase this and these low values on brakings, but let's try first just this. Put the minimum value that there is always to the 35%, and same to the left foot braking map. I'm not sure if this is necessary, but I want to do it just to be sure that there is always that 35% at least on the lock. Because it was a problem on the setup, on the previous setup, that it's so easy to spin on these junctions. You know, when you touch the handbrake, everything, the grip you have, it's like gone away. I think the speed of the suspension travel looks better, but it also starts to look quite crazy because of the length of the springs. But as I said, I will try shorter springs. I have also new pedals that I didn't have last time when I tested this, so I think I have to add a little bit brake pressure. Stiffer pedals. A lot. Better but more stiff. It feels quite good now on the junction. Let's see the difficult corner and the downhill braking. That felt bad last time. That also, I didn't lose the rear anymore because of the preload. So it gives more trust to the car, it's more easier to be confident, and it also faster. It's not a fast way to lose the rear of the car. Yeah, I really like the stability. It's already a lot better. The braking stability, but still the turning in is good. Also here, now the car is turning. The floor of the car is touching on the ground quite easily because of the softer front damper. Is yeah, a lot better. Now I think it's really close, which is good, because as I say, I don't want to go any softer, or at least a lot more softer anymore. Two fast corners. Yeah, so... Oh. That was maybe too good now. The turning in was amazing. It was perfect, but then I lose the rear. Ah. I had to do something. The rear also. Something that is not affecting to the turn in. It was like close to the apex where I lost the rear. So it's maybe the roll bar or then the... What is it? Damping slow area of the rear dampers. Maybe the roll bar, because it was basically just on the apex. So I have basically two options. To decrease the rear roll bar stiffness or increase the front roll bar stiffness, and because the car is quite soft on the suspension wise, I think I'm going to increase this a little bit because I don't want to make it any softer. After I have tested the stiffer springs and if they are good, then I can go back with the front roll bar and decrease the rear roll bar. But now, the current suspension, I will try this and just hope now that the turning in is not ruined. Was there something else I can try on the same time? Not maybe. Camper could also be something that I could increase if the rear still steps out on the fast corners. But let's try first the roll bar. And yeah, I can make the brakes a little bit more overful now. Add 250 and then a little bit to the rear, so we have the same brake balance, 65% on the front. I forgot to take something to drink. I will not have my drink. Oh no, no pumping, just
three,
fast run.
3, 2, 1, go!
I will check the rake. Because we have now a little bit softer front. Quite good. If you remember on the previous video, we see on the real life videos that the rear of the car is all the time at the same level or higher than the front of the car on the fast road setup that they were using. I think it was the Thierry Neuville and Otanak test videos that we watched. I'm not 100% sure about that roll bar. Yet it has been good, but let's see further. A little understeer there. It was a bit too stiff. Like the rear front tires went over the grip. There was not that bite through the full corner anymore. Here also. So I'm not going to use that roll bar. Definitely no. I'm going to try to add more camper to the rear. That doesn't matter. I already knew it. This was a bad thing. So let's try with the higher camper. This will not affect at all to the turning, I think. Or if there is some a little effect, it's so small that at least I'm not able to feel it properly. Maybe a little bit more preload also to the front. Make the front pull more to the straight at the exit of the corners. That is so difficult. There's like zero grip and little bumps on that junction. I really hate that place. Too early brakings now, because I have more braking power all the time. Let's now try to make it a big road, so I can see how the camper affects. So now becomes the corner when I lost the rear last time. And I lost it again. Really annoying, because I like to turn in now so much. But that is not good and not a realistic behavior on the fast places. Not at all. I didn't feel any benefits for that camper, so let's take it back. You have to be honest to yourself. Let's try. Let's just try a little softer. Or now I know. Let's put it a lot softer. And let's make the rear roll bar stiffer. And I tell you why. Because now the rear of the car stays easily on the down all the time, but it won't be too soft and too rolling because of the roll bar. That is my plan. Because if I make the bump so soft that I make, it will be too soft and really unbalanced. So I put a little bit more roll bar and hope this is a good way to go. Because on that problematic corner, when the rear is all the time a little bit closer to the road, there will be a little bit more grip, I think, and I hope. I'm not sure about the roll bar value, which is enough. Maybe it's something like 12.4 or 13.2 or something, but let's try first this and make changes if needed. And if this is a good way to go, anyway, I don't know. But I think it may be a good way. Get the rear more easily all the time closer to the road. but still not too much sideways rolling of the body. See how it looks. It looks quite soft, to be honest, but I think it will not look so soft when I add stiffer and shorter springs. Didn't like at all. There was understeer after the junction now. I'm starting to feel that I need to do some kind of a compromise, and I don't like it at all.
3, 2, 1, go.
I'm also thinking that opening the rear differential, but I feel it's more coming on the suspension than on the differentials, the rear lost that happens on that fast place. Or maybe I can use a little bit more lock on the rear throttle differential if I'm using this setup. Okay, I will go over that corner, because I want to test the other corners as well. It is quite a big change. Quite different to drive now. But I don't. Because I'm streaming and I will put this on the YouTube, I don't want to crash all the time on the same corner, so let's test it this fast now. No, it's not good. It's so soft. And now I really hope that it's not good on that fast corner. I hope it will be rubbish, because then it's so easy to decide that I'm not going to use that kind of setup on the rear. Yeah, it's so soft, and I think even using a stiffer roll bar is not the solution. The dampers are too soft. It feels like there are no dampers at all. Now, let's hope this is bad. And it's not. It was really good. Maybe I do a little compromise. I came 0.5 down on the dampers, so I put 0.25 more. Yes, it was 1.75, the original value. So let's try this. A little bit softer roll bar. And then, okay, let's try this first, but then I think I could use a little bit more rebound on the front, because these are like pairs, you know, the bump on the rear and the rebound on the front. Basically, you can decrease a little bit the bump value and increase the rebound value. I don't know how to tell it to you, but they work a little bit like on pairs. So if your car is like feeling too soft all the reactions, you can, for example, increase the bump value and decrease the rebound. And if you want it more grip and more solid and that kind of behavior, you can increase the rebound and decrease the bump value. Same, of course, the rear rebound and the front bump value. They are like pairs. Yeah, but let's test this now. then I'm going to add a little bit of rebound to the front. On some run I told that I maybe want a little bit more preload on the front. Keep some grip to the exit of the corners. But that rebound, stiffer rebound could be the solution for this, or for that also. Struggling a lot with the English speaking, it's a long time again. But I have got a huge amount of good feedback. Like private messages on the Discord and everywhere. I'm really happy. It seems that there are people who like to see this kind of material and who likes the work that I'm doing and the way how I'm doing it, you know, aiming the realistic behavior. So I'm going to continue this kind of video for sure. Even with my English skills. They are not perfect, but it's enough, I think. Actually, it feels quite good now. But let's see that fast corner again. I think when all the other corners are good, then it may be that the fast corner is bad. Let's see. Last time I hope it will be bad. Now I really hope it will be good. We should get some Hyundai driver to test this setup. Like, I know that Craig Breen, he has a Richard Burns rally. I don't know if well, there was a little losing moment. Let's do a little change. But yeah, I don't know if Terry Neuville or Oitanak or Danny Sordo has Richard Burns rally. Just a little bit. I'm not going to add the rebound to the front yet. I want to first. But yeah, it would be amazing to get a feedback from, for example, the Craig Breen. Especially from the Craig Breen, because he has been doing the fast gravel events.
3, 2, 1.
So he knows really well how the car is on the fast gravel. And what kind of setup is needed for the fast gravel. I don't know how to make that kind of thing happen. I'm not a friend of Gregory. I don't know him. There's maybe just tiny bit too much rolling now on the rear, but I can live with that if the handling is good on that fast corner. And on this stage, it's so easy to feel that the car is rolling too much because the shapeness of the road. There is all the time a negative road camper on the another side of the road and a positive road camper on the other side. So it feels a bit strange. A thing that I don't like at all. Same kind of thing that is, for example, on the Green Hills. The original Richard Burns rally stage. But it is realistic, on Finland the roads are the shape of the roads is that kind of many times. I have never think why, but I now when I'm thinking, I think so the water can fall off to the ditches. Hey! It wasn't bad. And it is not bad on the small road either. I think it's quite good compromise at the moment. Here on the right side of the road I have been spectating many times in real life. A little bit before that corner and also on these jumps, now here on the right. I'm 27 years old and I think I have been here something like in 20 different years. At least. Because I can't remember a Rally Finland on my living time. That the Ruuhimäki is not here on the road. It's either the shakedown or then normal stage. Nowadays it's a power stage. Pretty often. How about big jumps and landing? Antonen, what do you mean? How about big jumps? Now I'm going to test the preload. Not preload, rebound. I'm all the time mixing those two. A bit more rebound if it's good. And then I can test the springs, the stiffer springs, and see how it affects to the jumps. And for that I'm going to the owning pohi. One more test here on the Ruuhimäki. Did I save it correctly? And why I am now increasing that rebound value is that I want a little bit more grip to the front on the exit of the corners. I felt it before I make the change to the rear bump value, and especially now when the rear bump is a bit softer, I need a stiffer rebound to the front. Or I think I need. Let's see if I'm right or not. 3, 2, 1, go. A lot better at the exit of that. Same thing here, I was just a bad driver. Not sure about that, it's so difficult junction that I don't mind. So random how the car behaves. I do. Yeah, here on the Ruuhimäki my main point was to test the suspension travel and the speed of the suspension travel in when braking and the behaving on the corners. I'm making the suspension, or at least the damping, a bit softer to get more grip, because on the real life, when I was on the passenger seat, there was so much grip that I definitely need more grip. And I also need a more stiffness to the suspension if I want to make this closer to the real life. So now after this, if I can do the run without any crashes, I will go to the Ouninpohja and try a little bit stiffer and shorter springs, how it affects to the jumping behavior, because the jumping behavior was extremely good on the previous setup, and I don't want to disturb that at all, because this is a big road setup.
3, 2, 1, go.
I was hot lapping the stage, so it's not easy to drive this now a little bit over. That's why those crashes are coming. Of course I was crashing all the time when I was hot lapping, but it's... Oh, I have that ghost car on. Let's see if I can through pass it. If I can pass it so it won't be there visible. Like that, yeah. Now I think the ghost car is gone. Those was two good corners. My heart rate raised a bit. I got adrenaline when I wanted to pass that car on the street. I think I like the stiffer. What was that? Rebound. On every corner there hasn't been any bad corners, and on some corners it's a lot better. Now let's see that fast tricky corner. Ow. Yes, no problems. Oh, now we have problems, yeah. But I was, there was the ghost car. I was celebrating already. And I think it's good. Let's try, test the springs now. Then I'm extremely happy if I can use 10mm shorter springs without disturbing the jumping behavior. Of course with the stiffer spring I can also try a little bit lower ride height maybe, but let's see. Not necessary because we can check.
3, 2, 1, go.
You know, it doesn't seem too high compared to the real. Yeah, it's so good. And I think I put a lot of effort for this right hake and the rake the last streams. I don't want to change it. If I do something, I put 10mm shorter and stiffer springs at the stiffness so much that I can reach the same right hake with the 10mm shorter main spring. I did a really quick skin on the car, Lönn setup skin, before the stream. Well, that was extremely good behavior to that tricky junction. It helped a lot that we have now a stiffer preload, and because of the softer pump values on the front, the car is still turning. A little bit like Oh, I went off. Don't crash, don't crash, okay. It was a little like understeery moment. When I lost the grip, it happens first on the front of the car and then on the rear. It was like too unbalanced. I would like to add a more roll bar to the rear, but as we seen on the Ruuhimäki, then it will cause some problems. So I have to think, maybe a little bit more preload to the, no, rebound to the front, or then more camber to the front. Or maybe even a little bit less tire pressure. Let's see. And let's see if I can feel it on the, some other corners as well. If there is one corner on the wall stage, then it's not problem of the setup, then it's just a difficult corner. That's how I think. I don't like how much the car is touching on the ground or on the pump stops. You can hear that sound. Like now. And now. Because the softer pump values, I think. But it will be fixed with the stiffer suspension. Not so easy to try this first time now. A long break without any notes. And especially as I have been testing here on the other cars. And even if you have a good setup on every car, they are still different. This is a long wheelbase car and a low high rake setup, so it's a lot different than, for example, the Fiesta R5. The old one that I have been testing. It is a really short wheelbase car with a low rake in real life, which means that also a low rake on RBR with my setups. This is totally catastrophe now, the driving back. So far so good. If I can make it to the jumps, to remember how the jump behaving is, then I can do some changing and see if the jumping behavior is going worse or even better, who knows. To be honest, I don't know how it could be any better. I don't know, 50 to 70 hours I have been testing the Yaris WRC and also a little bit on other cars because the jumping behavior is so bad. It's like crazy. There is no point at all. And then there is this Hyundai i20 with a perfect jumping behavior. Oh, let's see if this is perfect now. Okay, there was a little kick. Little kick, I think it must be because of the slow area changes I did. We have the old setup. A few jumps for this. If it's any different, I'm not going to drive the wall stage. I just skip straight away to the jumps. I want to see if there is that little kick on this setup. I hope there is, cause as I said, I don't want to make it any worse on the jumps.
3, 2, 1, go!
But otherwise, those changes that I did felt really good. Also here on the Ounin pohja, not only there on the Ruuhimäki. Feels that the rear of the car is softer because the front of the car is so much stiffer now on this. Yeah, there was, it was the kick, but it didn't cause that little small problem that there was on the new setup. But let's see. Right there. Stiffer springs, so we have 350 mm ride height here on the front for the spring and increase the stiffness so we can reach the same ride height again. As close as we can get. Then we have 355 on the rear. Increase this more because it was already stiffer. Well, I think we are now. Let's try. Now we are as close as we can get. 155. Let's check the front one more time, yes. And let's see. Now I really hope that the jumping is still good. It would be really nice. Because it is a little bit too soft, the suspension, compared to the real life. Compared how the car looks on real life, and for example how the R5 felt on real life. You know, it was amazing how stiff the car is. Compared to the Richard Burst Rally. And the setups that I have been doing, and I have still, you know, I have been doing a lot stiffer setups than the default setups. And it seems that the cars on the real life are even more stiff than my setups. So the contrast between a default setup and the real life. But it's something that you can see on the replays, for example. That's not a big news. There is still quite a lot of travel. And now with the stiffer spring, I think that the rear is going down. Maybe a bit too fast. And I think it maybe was the reason of that little problem on the jump, that the low area of the rear was softer. Because the end of the compression of the fast pump will go to the slow area, of course. Because before the movement stop, it needs to be slow. That's really logical. Even a fast pump will be slow pump before it stops. Not so much grip on the rear at the exit of that. There comes the corner where I felt a little bit understeer. I think if I'm going to use this spring stiffness, I need to add rebound. Because you have a stiffer spring, it's coming up faster. And it's maybe a bit more nervous now. Or it's nervous, but it's too much, I think. Not so stable anymore. Yeah, definitely needs more rebound to the front. We are still quite a lot on the pump stop, so you can hear the sound now. But it's... Because also on the real life you can hear that the car is touching to the ground and... So, it's not so simple when you are touching the ground and when you are touching the pump stops. Here on the Ridge and Burns Valley. Thank you. I think that a little shorter helper spring and longer mainspring I could avoid a bit that touching on those pump stops. But it's opposite what I liked. Come on, now I'm going to skip straight away to the jumps. It's an opposite what I want to do based on what I see on the replay or on this outside view when I'm pumping the suspension. I don't want to make the mainspring and the suspension trouble in any longer. Or now when I'm thinking, maybe I can try. Like, take a 10mm off from the helper spring and put 5mm more on the mainspring. It should keep the ride height something like the same level. And it will help a little bit on that we are now touching the pump stops quite often. Let's skip to the jump. And see how the car jumps now with the stiffer and shorter mainspring. I'm afraid that there will be some problems. Come on. Well, it was better. Yes, this is good now. I think it, when I make the pump value of the rear damper softer, it didn't work together with the soft and long spring. But now when I have a stiffer and shorter spring, it works again on pump wise or jump wise or landing wise, whatever you like to think or however you want to think. I'm smiling all the time because I'm smiling on my own speaking. So random. But it's not the problem, the setup is going on the right way. That's the main thing. This is not a, oh, that was a really nice, that like bump where I was jumping. Yeah, this is not a speaking stream. This is not any that kind of thing stream. This setup stream. Where you, I want to do good setups. What I was planning to do? I was planning to do a little changes to the helper and mainspring length. So let's see the ride height again, 315mm. So let's take 5 longer mainspring and 10mm softer helper spring. And let's see, yeah, a little bit higher. So let's go back with the stiffness so we can reach the 350mm. Yep. And then same to the rear, we have 355 ride height. Let's go put a longer mainspring, 10mm shorter helper spring, and then I think a little bit back with the stiffness so we can reach the 355 like that. Okay, now it's interesting to see how it looks when pumping on the brakes and gas and how it behaves on basically everywhere and especially on the jumps. And if we are not touching the pump stop so easily, that was the main point why I was doing that change. Doesn't look too bad. I don't know, maybe on the rear I could do another that kind of change. The front seems to go quite down, but the rear doesn't. But of course it is also to maintain the high rake all the time that we were able to see on the real life videos, the previous streams. If I make a longer spring to the rear, longer mainspring, it will fall more close to the ground. Try this. it feels quite a lot softer. Surprisingly lot. Even that 5mm longer spring, it feels a lot more than 5mm what comes to the suspension travel in when braking. The 5mm, it sounds really small distance, and well, it is. But when you add it on the main spring, it's easy to feel. I was just going to end this and skip to the jumps, cause got the information wanted. We are still touching on the pump stops quite a lot. Not sure if there was any changes at all. But then I'm not 100% sure if it's the both pump stops or if it's just on the rear or on the front. I think it's on the front most of the time. The landing was a little bit worse now, so I'm not going to keep this change. Yep. Well, let's try the. I want to drive the pump again. It was so good last time. It comes next when we jump and land straight away to the pump. Here and now. Like, perfect landing and not so much perfect driving after that. But so often the car bounces again to the air on that place. Let's test on the savulampi. Next. Because it's good to test on the stages. Let's undo the setup change that we did last time. So 10mm back here on the helper and 5mm off on the mainspring. And then it was a bit stiffer. So we can reach the ride height. And let's do same on the rear. 5mm. Shorter main spring and 10mm longer helper spring and then a bit softer springs though. What did I? Now I did something from I do it. So random the ride height value. Let's do the rear first. So 5mm off here and 10mm more here. There was nothing random, it was just error on my brains. Now, it's good. Let's test how the car behaves here on the savulampi. Really nice stage that is done by Esko Kytömäki. Let's see how the car is here, and then I will just, if there is no problems anymore, I think I can just drive some stages. And maybe on Joukkovaara I could try if I can find a bit more grip again. Because the Joukkovaara is extremely familiar stage for me. I could try a little bit softer bump values. Still, both front and rear, and a little bit stiffer rebounds, both rear and front. If it will give a bit more grip without any problems. But then I don't know. Maybe it finished. It's so weird because this car has been so easy. Now, I should have maybe streamed the Yaris testing. There is now something like 70 hours. And basically there is many ways how to do the grip and the behaving good or extremely good. But whatever you do, whatever you try, the jumping will always be bad. I don't understand.
Three,
It's a totally nightmare. First time here with this car. Way too fast. Too late braking for that. Had to throw the car sideways. I feel like the now when we are on this new stage that the front damping or area damping could be a bit softer still. But let's see how it is on the some original format state as well, because there is a difference how the setup and car works on the BTP stages, like, well, this and only Pohjan Ruhimäki, and then how it works on the original format stages like Sirdonhed or Joukkovaara or whatever you like to drive. Oh, this is extremely slippy. Definitely need more grip here. Of course, this is a big road setup, but still, I think I'm lacking of grip compared to the other WRC setups that I have done. Jump! Nice. Yeah. On these slippery brakings, especially here on the small road, I want the front of the car to go down faster. Comment, sorry for stupid line. This is a crazy jump. Really crazy. But no problems. There's a really stiff compression here, but no problems. And another jump. All these jumps on this big road section are really crazy. And you know, this is a real life stage. This is crazy. But no problems. That little bounce is, it's not a problem. It was just a stupid, crazy big jump. Something that you will not do on the real life. This is extremely high. Yeah. There was a little like kick off the rear, but I can tell you that, for example, the Yaris, it will do the front flip when landing that jump. So that little kick with this car is not a problem. Let's try the wall stage. It's only 1.5 kilometers left. So you can see the stage if it's not familiar for you. There is a proper runkipaikka. Difficult braking, you can. This is really normal for me. I brake too late here. As I said, difficult braking. This is quite little but difficult jumps for the setup. Often bounce a little bit. Also these cuts here. Really big test for the setup. Well, that was the finish of the stage. It was really difficult that the final small road. But yeah, now I want to find grip. That was like really clear that, you know, the car is good what comes to the driving, but it will be faster if I find a little bit of grip. And it's not enough that the car is good to drive, it needs to be fast also. You are driving too fast. No that kind of comments today. Let's go to the Joukkovaara. Here I'm going to test if I can find more grip with the softer bump values and higher rebound values.
3, 2, 1, go.
It would be easy to find grip with the roll bars, but I don't want to make them softer, because as you see on the Ruuhimäki, really bad on some corners. Same thing here on the original format stage. I want the front to go down more quick. So let's start. Oh. Misclick. The clicking process goes different when you are on the RX plugin on the PTP stages and here on the original format stages. Sometimes there will be. But yeah, I want to try to this first. And if this is good, then I will maybe drop both. Like, first I want to balance this front bump value and the rear bump value. And then when these are good, like feels balanced, then I can decrease both of them and increase the rebound. If it will be a good way to find some grip. It's better, but now the rear of the car feels too stiff. I don't know. Let's try. Because it still feels that the weight transfer to the front is not enough. I'm still not feeling 100%. This may be crazy, but let's open a little bit the front rear rebound. Because I want to find the perfect balance for the slow area dampers before finding grip by chasing the setup. First the balance, then the grip. My rule.
3, 2, 1, go.
It is really high now, how the rear of the car feels. Yeah, I'm not going. Definitely not. Then I think my only option is to keep this decreasing this value. Afraiding all the time that it will ruin the jump behavior. But basically it is the rear that will cause the problems before the front, so maybe this is not bad. Let's try this one more time and maybe then the balance is good, then I can search some. Ah, stupid line, but no crash. Still I'm not, but I think if I add the rebound it can make it better. Like on the entry of the corner and the apex, I feel that it's too difficult to keep the front of the car down, but at the exit of the corner it's not problem anymore. Then it's more problematic with the rear, it's quite slippery here, but it's a classic problem and classic situation that on the PTP stages it feels that the rear is a little bit lower compared to the original format stages, and you always have to do a compromise if you are not doing a different setup for both of the stage types, which I'm not going to do because this is meant to be a like overall big road gravel setup that you can use everywhere on this. I'm not 100% sure about that change. I think I will keep it, but then test again on the, for example, on the Ruuhimäki, how it feels. Or maybe not, it's too nervous now. Maybe some drivers could handle it, but this is going to be a setup for everyone, so there's no point to make it too aggressive. Let's change this back, and basically now I think we have the good balance, or at least a good compromise between the slow area front and the slow area rear. And now let's do the change that I was talking about. Let's drop the slow bumps 0.25 and increase the rebounds, slow rebounds 0.25. Maybe this will give some grip. See how it feels. It seems better. It seems more logical and more realistic for me. And yeah, there's more grip, especially on the front. It's maybe a little too... Something on the rear is missing. Somehow it should be a bit softer. But straight away I'm not sure which is the way. And if I'm not feeling that problem on the PTP stages, then I will leave it how it's on now, because I think, I hope, and people are moving to the Hungarian blogging from the Czech blogging. And on the Hungarian blogging, as there is lot of PTP stages available on the online. People are driving those PTP stages, those there are some good stages, some real life stages, new stages coming all the time. So the setup needs to work on the PTP stages as well. Basically it was easier on the check plugin when those were only the original format stages that was used on the online races. Yes, let's go to the Ruuhimäki and see how it feels, and if it's possible I will try. But of course it's possible, but if it's good without problems, I'm going to try to decrease the rear roll bar stiffness a little bit. I think I got a flashback at the beginning of the stream. I said that now I don't want to decrease the, or then I didn't want to decrease the rear roll bar stiffness because we had that soft suspension. But now we have a stiffer suspension, a little bit shorter suspension. So maybe I can decrease a little bit the rear roll bar stiffness. And also because we have a softer pump values and stiffer rebound values, that change should keep our car more close to the ground all the time. So there will not be so much body roll. But let's first try how it feels now after the changes that we done on the Ounin pohja and on the Joukkovaara. The Ruuhimäki was the stage where this stream begins, or basically the siirron head, but here I did the first changes. Generally, I'm happy that I can give you a setup that is not spinning so easily anymore. I was a bit upset because of the later setup, because it was spinning, and I hope that people will find this video on the YouTube and they can download this new and better setup. Or at least if they feel that this is not a better setup, they can copy the preload and maybe the rear brake lock settings and the center diff settings and the changes that I did to avoid that spinning, if the spinning was a problem, but I think that it was for many people. At least it was not realistic, the car was spinning so easily. So much better through that turn in now. So definitely there is some progress. Okay. And who knows, maybe this is now the last time I'm changing this setup. Then on the next time I will do some Torback setup. Or something that many people has been hoping since the last setup streams. I think I can do it on the WRC car as well. It's also a learning for me. Like 3 years since I have been doing a proper tarmac setup for modern WRC cars. 6 has changed. Then it was NCP5, now we have NCP6, and I hope that my knowledge has been changing as well to the better direction. And well, I know it has because I got the real life experience, but also on other ways I think I'm a better setup maker now. I was 10, so it'll be interesting. And interesting just to drive these modern cars to the tarmac because of the huge downforce. I think it will be fun even if I am not a good tarmac driver. Yeah, basically there was not no problems at all. Let's try that roll bar thing, it should keep. Give a little bit grip to the rear. Let's go back to the 12.0. The value where we started, I think. Old setup. Yeah. Same value. And now if there is no problem here with the software roll bar, then I think I will do just some stages again and see if I can feel any problems, and if no, then I'm done. The setup is ready.
3, 2, 1, go.
So I don't really know what to test anymore on the big gravel. Maybe some original format stages more. But there has now been jumps and corners, slow corners, fast corners, junctions, hard breakings. Everything has been tested again. That is the trickiest corner of the stage if you want to drive fast. It's not the most annoying, the second proper 90 junction is most annoying corner. But that is really hard. It's so little that you have pace, it's so narrow. You can't really cut and you can't run wide. Not sure if it would be good to add a little bit brake pressure to the front brakes. That is something I want to test. And I can test now, because this is not... Now it's inside my head, I'm afraid too much that corner. I'm braking too early, driving too carefully, and it's not working. I'm losing the downforce because my speed is so low. Okay. What do you think, my viewers? Would it be better to do a tarmac setup for WRC car or R5 car? Do you have any opinions? I'm not sure when I'm going to do, but it will be the next that kind of project that I'm going to stream and record on the YouTube as well. Yeah, it was better, the braking. All you who are watching this later on the YouTube, hopefully there is someone. You can comment it on the YouTube comments. What do you want, R5 or WRC? Or I'm not sure about the brakes. Basically, the first part, the heavy braking is better, but the end of the braking, it's a little bit like understeer, you know. Yeah, it's not turning too good anymore, I will change it back. Back to where it was. Now let's try to do the wall stage. See the roll bar, how it affects, and then do other stages, and then I think I'm ready if there will be no problems. But I'm not going to release this if there is some problems. I don't want to do. This should be perfect now. Before I release and share this setup for or to everyone. Yeah, it is better now. Better now, especially the end of the braking. So, I'm afraid so much that corner now. Touch it a little bit of the stone. I'm not 100% sure. Maybe I go 0.2 back. 0.2 more stiff there. Roll bar. Some places it feels. Or I'm not sure if the rear roll bar is too soft, but the balance between the front and rear roll bar, it's too much towards the rear. Just a little bit, just a tiny thing. Maybe I can try to also a softer front roll bar, 0.2 softer. That would be a better solution on grip wise than increasing the rear roll bar stiffness. Yeah, that's something I'm going to test here on the Ruimäki. And then I think I need to go do a one jump run on the Ounin pohja, because we have again a little bit different dampers. Slow area, but those are affecting landing a little bit. Morjesta, Michaels. Welcome to the setup stream. It's now like fine-tuning. There is no big problems anymore. And it has been good. The car is better and more realistic now than on the beginning of the stream. And that was the purpose of this stream. So it has been good, but just a little fine-tuning and testing on different stages if I can still find something to improve before releasing the setup. I think it is good, but now again, if you remember on the beginning of the string, there is that one killer fast corner, and always when some change feels good on the wall state, there is that one corner which kills and destroy everything. And yeah, it's only a one corner, but the behaving that I had on the beginning of the stream, the totally lost of the rear, it is something that is not, that should not happen never ever. So I'm not going to allow that kind of behavior at all. Now it comes slight left, and then let's see if the car is rotating too much now with the softer roll bar on the front. No, it's really good. Really, really good now. Always the same, when I say it's really good, then I took some bad line. What next? Let's do a check on the owning boy, just the jumps. That it's still good. And then let's do the Sirdonhed, Lochard, Undva. Maybe Nybobs also, some original format stages to see how the car behaves. So something like half hour more testing, and then I think I can be happy. And again, I'm just hoping that there is no problem. Because then I don't know what to do. Or I know, but I don't want to do it. I don't want to go deeper with the slow area. Bumps! Ah! It was quite a big kick. Let's see the other ones. They are all good, then I... It's not a big... I tried one thing. One little thing. To decrease a little bit of the fast ramp threshold. There is a little fine tuning, which means that now the damping is a little longer on the fast bump side before it goes to the slow bump side, which is now softer than it was when the stream started. Let's do a little check that the slow area bumping is not going to the fast bump. Just and just, I think I can live with it, or with that. Jumping is good. No, niin, that was a winner's word, but now it's good again. I was really hoping that little change will work, and it worked. And I think it will not be a problem on the slow corners. That the threshold is a little... There's a little bit less threshold now. checking to the phone already. Okay, now the jumping is good and the behaving is good, at least on the PDP stages, I think. And I think the grip that I can get easily now to this setup is quite close to the maximum. If I want more grip, then I have to change a lot more. And because the handling of the car is so good and the jumping is perfect, I don't want to change. Definitely not. So now let's just test some stages. Well, let's go to the Loch Ard. Also a really difficult test for the setup on jump wise. It's so bumpy, the landing of the first jump. It feels better now with the softer roll bar, I can tell you already, than it felt on the joukkovaara with the stiffer roll bar. But I don't know. I don't know the correct word in English, but there is a little moment when I touch the brakes. When the front is not going down as quick. I try one more time this. If it helps. I really don't know what other to ride than the slow area bump. Definitely not the roll bar. And I don't want to make the suspension any softer. I don't want to add the rake. Because the rake seems so realistic. Basically feels quite good. Okay, now there is... Now it was a lot better, but let's see if it's too soft for or on some situations. Yeah, now the car is turning also here. Good behaving through those bumps. Stupid mistake. I think it would be better to drive a little bit slower on that kind of streams, but I always want to. Udva is not a proper big road, but it's gravel and it's quite slippery and extremely difficult. So I like to test here also, through a quick test, because if the car is really difficult to drive, you will find out it here really
Three,
quickly.
Two, one, go.
Now I need to put the notes on, I don't remember.
Shot 3 right, 200. Double caution, short 2 right to the crest, to narrow, 100. Caution, to narrow, short 5 left, into short 3 right, 100. Double caution, 3 right to narrow, and 2 left, plus long, to narrow, and 4 right, 70. Short 6 right, 60. short full right, double caution, 17, 3 left, extra long, double tightens, to narrow, and 2 right, 30.
Maybe it's the
two right to narrow,
front brake lock that is too open, and because of that I'm not feeling the bite or grip of the braking that I would like. Let's try. Okay. Front brake diff. But we have rear. Okay, we have 60 rear, 50 on the front. Don't waste a good stage to test. So difficult. If the car is not turning good and if there is something surprises all the time on the behavior of the car, you will find out it here. The car needs to be really logical here on the Untwa.
Double caution, short 2 right over crest, to narrow 100, caution to narrow, short 5 left, into short.
Ah! But that is also a classic Untwa. Rocks everywhere. Was a bit crazy cut, I have to say. But I want to push.
3, 2, one. Short five right, 17.
Let's take it more easy
short
now.
Four left and six right, tightens. Don't cut into short three left over crest. Over strong 100. Short three right, 200. Double caution. Short two right over crest to narrow 100. Caution to narrow. Short five left into short three right 100. Double caution. Three right to narrow and two left. Plus strong to narrow and four right 70. Short six right 60. Short four right. Double caution. 70. Three left. Extra long. Double tightens to narrow and two right 30. Two right to narrow, 70. Two left, tightens, don't cut, and two right, opens, 30. 90 right, don't cut, 30. 90 left, minus, maybe, 50.
I think it there's a really clear difference.
Right, don't cut.
Clear difference. It is for sure better on the braking and like bite. More aggressive and makes the front of the car to go down more quick. Not 100% sure. Making the turning in a little bit too difficult. But let's see if I can feel something like that. Other stages. Otherwise, the behaving was extremely logical. Could be a little bit longer and softer springs for the Untwa stage, but it's not basically the stage to where this setup is done for. Let's next go to the new box. Then I think to the Sirton head and then we are really close to finish.
3, 2, 1.
Maybe one more Ownin pohja, because again we have a little bit softer damping. Oh, what was that understeer? What was that understeer on there, on these first corners?
Four left, three right, into over crest, 80, five left, long, 120.
Why the front of the car is not baiting to the road at all here?
Four right. 4 left, 40, 5 left, 40, 4 right, long, 40.
Or it is not so bad, but there is a little
keep middle into jump, 80, 6
little
right,
difference
100.
I can feel.
6 left, long, 180.
Not sure if it's because of the surface of the road.
90 left,
drive more.
5 left, 120.
Where's the braking pod? I don't remember. Oh, it was too late.
5 left, 120. 4 right, 40. 3 left, 120. 4 right, 60.
What is this? I don't understand. I need to do again and make sure that I load the proper setup. Because on the Jaukoar, on the Lochard, on the Undva, on the PTP stages, the front was fighting and there was grip. But now, on the new box, it doesn't feel so good.
6 left, blown at 40.
5 right, blown at 120. Of course, I could adapt on my driving wise, but I don't want to. I want that the setup is good and perfect. This is like a new situation for me, but here on the Australian gravel, the feeling is so much different. Confusing. Now let's try to see the breaking point. Yeah, I think. Way too early. What is this understeer? No matter if it's a turn in, apex or the exit of the corner, the front is not biting. There is no that amount of grip that there was on the other stages.
To right 50. 5 left long, into caution, keep left 60.
Try one thing. I'm not sure if I'm going to use this, because all the other stages there was not that problem. But I just want to see if it helps to add a little bit rebound to the front. Or maybe tire pressure are the solution. Well, let's try this, then the tire pressure. A 5 kPa off from the front, or 5 kPa more to the rear.
6 left, blown, 40.
It is better now.
4 left, 3 right, into overgrass, 80. 5 left, blown, 120.
But then it's a bit oversteerly. I don't get the waste transfer to the rear, the exit of the corners as fast as I would like, and I would need to get the grip.
6 right, 100. 6 left, bomb, 180. 90 left.
I don't remember how the tire pressures are on this setup. I think there is 175. The front and 160 on the rear, something like that. 10 or 15 kps difference. I'm not going to use that. Back. Then let's see the tires. Oh, there was so much on the front, so let's decrease a little bit. And if this is not working, then I think I have to just leave the problem. Because it was so good on the other stages. It's not working. Would it be the camper? Maybe the camper, because if you remember, there was the one corner on the Owinpohja where I said that the front loses the grip too early compared to the rear. And then I think it may be a camper thing. Let's try the camper. Room. to add a bit more camber because it's 0.75. Pressure back where it was. Then camber to the one. How it looks outside of the car.
3, 2, 1, go.
Quite balanced with the rear. Not looking too unrealistic. Seems that there's a little bit more maybe on the rear, but I'm not sure. It depends so much on the angle that you are watching. But anyhow, it seems realistic for me, not like too much.
For right block 15, for left 60.
Okay, that was 40. That was the thing. Now we are talking about again. That was the thing. I was missing camber on the front. Of course, there's a negative side effect now that the braking grip on the front tires are not so good. But I can live with that. Because, you know, on the big road, big gravel setup, the braking is not the main thing. The behaving on the fast corners and the jumps is the thing.
Right 40, 3 left 120. For right 60, 3 left into caution, keep
for sure it is still not perfect for this, or at least on that stage. I'm lacking grip a little bit. The roll bar could be softer, but on those, especially on those fast finish PTB stages, I can't use softer roll bars. It will be too unstable.
5 left, 5 right, 100.
3 right, 80. Maybe it is just because the gravel here on the Australia is more slicker. At least it sounds really logical. But it's now 40. So difficult. Right, and also it sounds really logical that you can fix the problem with the roll bars.
3 left, 400.
Because it's so clear that it's the sideways grip. Both on rear and on the front. There's no grip enough.
4 left 40, 4 right 80.
And you know, the car is not rotating sideways
right
at all.
Caution.
Those
three left 60.
Roll bars are definitely too stiff for this stage. And this is the fastest. Or I think it's the second fastest stage of the Australia. I think in Minnesoft is more fast, so it'll be even worse on the east-west, for example, on all the green hills. Where it's also quite fast. I don't know, I don't like the green hills this run. So what next? I think one more run on the Ouninpohjan Ruuhimäki, because we have now a little bit different setup and a little bit different pump value in the front, and then if everything is okay, I will do the thing that I have been doing on the end of the previous streams as well. Let's drive the Sirton head and then watch the replay. Let's watch the replay to see how the car looks, and then stream and set it to download to the YouTube, and on the description of the video there will be a link where you can download this setup. I will also put this to the Finnish community. So all the Finnish viewers, you can download the setup.
3, 2, 1.
Before it comes to the YouTube.
Right,
I think it will 16. Be tomorrow. When six I can put this grand. Video onto the YouTube.
17. 5 left, minus, double tightness. The crest, long. And that's your 6 left, opens, up to crest. Double caution, and 4 right tightens, into 1 right tightens, maybe don't cut, and 4 right opens, long, 100. Late 90 left to narrow, and that's your 5 right over crest, 150. Double caution, 90 left opens, up to crest, maybe, and 2 left, maybe, 40. Short 3 right plus, don't cut.
I'm trying to drive like no sideways, just to feel it that there is enough grip on the front. Now when there is a higher camper value, and it's feeling quite good. It's not my natural driving style. I like to go sideways more.
Give in, double caution, 50, 90 left, opens, maybe, and short 3 left, over crest, and short 4 left, up to crest. Keep it on the crest, into short 4 right, 4 left, to narrow, and 4 right, and short 5 left, into short 3 right, 3 left, to narrow, don't cut, and short 5 right, over crest. And 3 left, opens, maybe, into short 90 left, maybe, and 2 right, opens, long, maybe. And short 4 right to the crest, and short 90 right plus to narrow, into short 4 left, 4 right 50, 4 left over crest, and keep it on the crest, jump 100, short 6 right up to crest, and short 5 left 60.
So beautiful, so extremely beautiful, I can't understand after the auto WRC cars how the landing and jumping of this car is so good. I got an idea, after this run, I take the default setup and I want to see if it's because of the car or because of the setup, the good jumping. I haven't dumped this car with the default setup. I'm not 100% sure if it's just the car that is so good on the jumps compared to the... I mean, this is the behaving that you can see on the real life. But the behaving then, especially the Yaris, it is something absolutely bullshit. There's no point at all how it's behaving on the jumps. At least if you make it to... go low, the right head as it is on the real life. No way you can make it behave good on the jumps. Let's see now. Yeah, it's really good. Now I think I'm finished with this setup. There's no... basically no problems at all. Or at least I can't feel them. You can always do some fine tuning, but it's like that road will never end. I think I can be really happy with this. I was really happy before this stream, and now I am even more happy that I can share you that kind of setup. Veto paskaa bullshit. Bullshit. Let's try the default. How I can... if I don't download setup, I think I have default setup. Maybe, I'm not sure, I haven't never driven the default setup. The RX plugin. I can see it immediately on the start line. If I have it or not. If I don't have, I don't know how I can get it. go much lower.
Three.
You see how this is a boat, you know, a proper boat. It's so like slow and slow and slow and slow, all the movements. Let's do a little jumps. If the car is good on the jumps or if the setup is good. I think it can be the car also. It's really possible. So crazy low. Bottoming out all the time. Yeah, I think it is the car. Or then I haven't done this kind of test on the other WRC cars. But at least when I have done the suspension to look like in real life, then the jumping behavior becomes impossible. The Fiesta is a little bit better, but the Yaris is really difficult. I think I'm ready. Let's do the Virdon head run to get the replay and see how it looks. Replay cameras. Then ready. It took just 2.5 hours. Quite good. Not too much.
3, 2, 1, go.
What was that? Come on, why this? I want to do a new try. If the car is not better when I drive better, then there is a problem still. And the problem is the roll bars.
Two,
oh, sure. As I'm 100% sure, if the car is not sitting on the road, on those corners, then it's the roll bars. Yeah, it's not. Ah! Okay, it was not 2.5 hours, I think it will be. I meant to save this. And now, let's do go 1.0 down both front and the rear. And now I have to test it again on the on some BDP stage, maybe on the Ruuhimäki, because there will be the problems on the fast road if there will be some problems because of the softer roll bar. Yeah, this is the struggle. If anyone knows why is the setup feeling so much different on the BDP stages that it is on the original format stages, it would be really nice to know, and if there is some way to fix it. Nice. Extremely frustrating. You know, both the stages are gravel, it's big road, basically should be quite same. But then the feeling is not. It feels that the rear of the car is higher, and it feels that the overall stiffness of the car is, you know, it's more stiff on the original format stages than on the BDP stages. same setup. Something that I can't understand. Still not, come on. It's, you know, sliding off the grip. Out of the grip. Go softer, more. If I can't make it good with the roll bars, then I have to touch to the springs and make the springs softer. That will be a long way to go. But I'm not giving up. I will do this. Okay. Or tonight. I just can't find the ways. If it will be totally impossible, then maybe not. I think now the front is good, but the rear isn't. The rear is still quite. I can add a little bit back the stiffness to the front roll bar. Because on the braking, it felt already quite loose. And at the same time, let's try a little bit more preload. Turn in extremely well now when the roll bars are softened. So a bit more preload to the rear to give us the stability. 3, 2, 1, go. Driving slow, I just try to feel the balance of the car and when and where is it front or rear that is going to lose the grip first. And I think I want to see the replay of this run just to be sure what is happening. Or not this, I make the rear softer and the front a little stiffer, then I... try this. How much is our... lock? Okay. 35% the throttle lock on the rear. I was thinking if I open it a little bit to give some stability, but because it's only 35%, I'm not going to open it. 3, 2, 1, go. I don't know, somehow I'm extremely uncomfortable now on this stage. You know, even the new pops there, the grip wasn't there. But the stability and the balance of the car was good. A bit understeer, but otherwise quite good. But here it's so difficult now, for some reason. I just can't understand why. Because this is not like something really special stage. This is a normal big gravel stage. Everything should have been good. But no. I'm still losing the rear too easily. Yeah, massive oversteer. let's drive these bumps and then see the replay. I think I want the rear to be more soft, and then I will try to make the rebound stiffer, because when you touch a low roll bars, I need more stability for sure. It looks slippery, but it doesn't look otherwise so bad. Maybe the rear is a bit lower than I think. I don't know why, because of course there is a softer damping on the rear, but there's a lot softer damping on the front, so it will not be the reason why there is maybe a bit lower than I think. But for sure it's not the problem, and it's not the problem for when aiming to the realistic setup, I think. But I think I'm not far away. Looks so good. Bit more softer roll bars and then stiffer rebounds on the low area. It looks so good. Can't be. Here you can see the when I added the camper, that when we are on the brakes, when the suspension goes down, there is quite a lot of camper, and it's like too much for the optimal braking grip. And on the rear it's the opposite. When braking, the rear goes up, and the camper basically decreases. So on the braking situations, it's not a problem to use a high camper on the rear, but high camper on the front is more problematic on for braking. Oh, maybe. And I make a little bit softer the front. Maybe not yet. The rear a little bit softer. Then I add some both front and rear to give some stability. That is gone. Do it. Soft roll bars. That's good. It can't be far away. It's somewhere really close. I know. Because of the triplay. And because it was so good on the other stages. Of course, there is now the risk that it is not so good on the other stages again. But I cannot accept that the setup was so bad on this stage. Why? Okay, maybe it was too much. The front rebound. Let's put it back where it was. You know, on the replay, it seems that the rear is lower than I think, but then when I'm driving, it feels like it's basically higher than I think.
3, 2, 1, go.
Thank you. But now it was better. That was good thing to add the rebound to the rear, but yeah. It's still I'm losing the rear on the middle corner, on the apex. The apex of the corner. Again, I just keep on losing the rear all the time. Let's try this 155 on the rear. Let's make a little bit longer mainspring and a little bit shorter helper spring. So now we have a 5mm more suspension travel in. If it keeps a little more grip rear. After that I will try to decrease the stiffness of the helper spring. If there will be no effect to the balance of the car or the stability of the car.
3, 2, 1, go.
Now it at least feels that the rear is more down. Okay, now it's a lot better. Now it's a lot better. Yeah, lot better. I think I still need more preload to give some stability. Car is turning in so well that I can use a higher preload on the rear. Just to avoid some unnecessary slides. So much better. I want to do another step like that. I can still make it better. Yep. Then I make the preload. Same time. Now I'm motivated again. It was a bad moment when I realized that the start was so bad here on the siirtymäkeet.
3, 2, 1, go!
Shorter rear is now lower than on the real life. I can feel it already, but I can live with that. If it will be good to drive, but still! It's so... I really don't know, or maybe I know what to do. Let's try the... Let's put the suspension thing back where it was. And then try to open the pump all the way through the 1.0.
Go.
Still it's sliding a little bit. On the middle and exit of the corner. I would like to add a little bit of camber, but I just add camber to the front to make the balance more oversteery. I don't want to add more camber, and we are on the 1.0 camber. More camber will be a bit unrealistic. Not 100% sure what kind of camber values they are using in real life, but I think it's close to the 1.0 on gravel. That was my mistake, not a setup mistake. Let's try to open the... just a little. 5% the diff. And then... increase the preload on the front to make the car like a bit more front wheel drive. Or the behaving closer to the front wheel drive, of course the car is still. I don't trust the car at all. Basically there is no more grip now on the rear, but because the lock is more open, the car is not oversteering anymore. Maybe it was good. Still something is missing. Something is missing because the car is like sailing. I know it's basically the roll bars, but when I make the roll bars stiffer, it's not giving me the grip. I want to test the old how it was when things were good. There's so much better things on that new version. But something is just missing. I'm not 100% sure what. What is the missing thing? Let's try if I can see it by testing the other setup. Well, it's as difficult maybe. Maybe I was aiming to do perfect or something that is not possible to do. Let's make it well, let's first make the damping pack, because I'm really afraid what this 1.0 value will do to the jumps. And then maybe a little bit more rear stiffness. How much we have? Okay, we have 0.5 toe angle on the front, so no. Oh, sorry, on the rear. So no more toe to the rear. And I think I open back these preloads. Also a little bit on the rear. Just go. I want to stay sometimes. I have to say that at least on previous years in Finland, in real life in Finland, the Hyundais have been struggling with the rear grip on fast sections. The rear has been sliding. The drivers are telling it all the time, or has been telling it on the stage end comments, that the rear is sliding. So basically that I can't make the rear bite. It is the rear biting is a realistic thing with this car. I'm not 100% sure if they fix it on the 2020, because this is a 2020 version. Or is it 2020 or 2019? I'm not sure. But at least on 2020 they didn't drive the Rally Finland at all because of the corona. Little small tuning still. Roll bars. Then I will test it on the PDP stage and hope. Basically, if I can make the softer roll bars to work, there will be more grip on every stage, so it is good. But I'm afraid that the balance is not so good. Okay, now I have the feeling, now I know where the grip edge is on that stage. Well, Ruhimäki. And all the changes that I'm going, I will remember the grip level on the Sirdonet. So I know the level and edge that I can't go over with the stiffness of the roll bar without problem on the Sirdonet. Basically on the front there is no room at all. If I make it 0.2 stiffer, I will go over the grip. The rear there is a little bit room, but then the overall balance may be too much towards the oversteer.
3, 2, 1, go.
Okay, so far so good. So, still afraid of that corner. But still so far so good for setup wise, not driving wise. Yes, looking really good. This is a proper test for the roll bars, if they are too soft or not. Oh, so far so really good. This is a positive surprise. Maybe a bit too soft rear, but I can live with it. Here I would like a little bit softer front. Let's see the fast killer corner. If there is no oversteer, I can make 0.2 softer roll bar to the front. Ah! You know, I'm still not used to the stiffer brake. And when I've been driving something like 3 hours, my legs get tired. Camera wasn't there when I think it will be. There was that oversteer, so I can't make the front roll bar any softer. Or sure not. On that corner also it would have been nice, but I can't make it because this is a big road setup, but I just can't share a setup that will do that kind of thing. Oh, maybe now it's still okay, but it will oversteers even more and even more rapidly. Something that I can share to everyone. And it is not realistic at all. Yeah, hello Antonin, nice that you are still there. I'm not sure if it's just this car. It might be the way how I feel the setup, how I drive, and it can be also my setup that the setup window is so close. And it can be that I'm doing at the moment so you know, fine tuning, that it seems that the window is so small. I don't know. But every time when I do setup, and I'm quite happy with the setup, the rest of the testing is just this kind of thing. You know, going 0.2 here and there and finding the perfect balance and the perfect compromise. I want to drive it again. Just to be sure. Let's drive with long gears. Oh, I just have to remember to change the gears back when I release the setup, because most of the stages is the medium box here, I think. And the top speed with the medium big box is somewhere close to the 200, which is realistic value. With this gearbox is much over 200 kilometers per hour.
3, 2, 1, go!
So difficult. There's like I said before, there's like zero grip on the middle of that junction. Avoid the hit to the corner, to the stone, and now I'm mid-line totally. I lost a good time there, but we can still test the setup. Feels so lazy the engine with the long gearbox. Yeah, it's not too bad. Stable enough. jumping is still really good. I really like how it is. I think the time would have been quite okay without those two mistakes. I lost something like seconds. World record at the moment is 255.1. My best time is 255.7. So if I take off those 2 second mistakes that I did, 256.4. So not bad at all. I wasn't really pushing. Well, driving the good pace to see how the setup works. But now, maybe now I'm ready. Maybe now I'm ready. Let's do the Siirdon head one more time and see the replay. And, you know, you already know the process because I have been saying this so many times because I have been thinking that I'm ready, but then I realize on the Siirdon head, oops, I'm not ready. Let's make the gearbox back to the medium. Start the stage. Would be nice to hear some feedback. Feedback also from this setup. You test it. On the YouTube comment or on the Discord on some Richard Burr's rally server where we are. Whatever. How you feel the setup? Here it's so easy to feel the difference when you drive first the BTP stage and then original format stage. The rear is higher, it's so clear, or at least it feels. I'm not sure if it's physically higher, but the setup feel like it is. The fate transfer to the front is more quick and better. And the rear is sliding all the time, it's not biting, and you know, you can like feel it. You get information on the view that you see, the, you know, position of the car, and you can feel and understand that seems that the rear is for some reason a bit higher here on the original format stages. I'm not alone with that opinion. Some other really good drivers here on the Finland at least, and good setup guys as well, have been saying the same. Even before I have tell this my opinion to him, so it's their own opinion. Again, the same thing on the Ruuhimäki junction. My leg is too tired to push the brake. But I like to keep the rear brake pedal. Not rear brake pedal, now I'm too tired, whole body and brain, but I want to keep the pedal like that, because it's so close to the realism. I just have to get used. When I start driving, I remember to push harder. But when I've been driving over 3 hours, I forgot how much I need to use power and brake. This was quite a messy run, but it's enough, I'm tired now. Happy because the setup is better, but tired because it's midnight. That's enough, I'm not going to drive anymore. Not going to drive anymore, let's see the replay and... start line the weight transfer to the rear, it seems slower than in feels. So who knows, at least on the original format stages there is room to maybe softer a little bit the front rebound. Yeah, you can see easily that the rear isn't biting so much. It would be nice to see a good replay from the BTP stages, but there are no replay cameras, so it's not so. We can try. I can try to make the camera angle to follow the car. So, let's check if there is some visible difference. But it is what it is. If you want to make a setup that is good everywhere, on the PDP stages and on the original format stages, you can't make a setup that is perfect. I think it's more calm now. The suspension works because of the softer pump and stiffer rebound. There was the stupid braking. Easy, I didn't even lock the tire, I just pushed too little the brake pedal. I think for rough gravel setup, definitely for the rough gravel setup, it is need to decrease the rake. Maybe 10 millimeters at least, I think. Or 10 to 15. No, sorry, 5 to 10 millimeters. If only for original format stage, rough gravel setup, maybe 10. And now there was the crash. Yet. Let's see. We can see the... Oh, we can't see because I don't have a replay from the PTP stages. Okay. Maybe we finish now, so... Thank you for watching. It was 3 hours again. And the point of this whole stream was to update the setup that I did earlier on the spring, or yeah, well, on the spring. And the point why I wanted to update was, there was basically 2 points. I wanted to make the car closer to the real, because I got the chance to be on the real rally car, on the modern rally car, Fabia R5. I understand some points. And another thing was that the car was spinning too easily on the junctions and on the hairpins. So I think now the car is closer to the real car. It's a bit more stiff and there is more grip. And everything, you know, the suspension trouble, those are happening faster. And it's not spinning. Now that problem is totally gone, at least on my driving. It's quite calm and easy to drive through the junctions now. So I think I can be happy. You will find the download link on the YouTube tomorrow and... yeah, thank you and bye bye.